Hi, I'm back. Okay, I've been sick. I have a cough drop in my mouth. So, please bear with me. I tried to look decent for you today, but I'm really sick. But I wanted to do a video because I had a request for a video on spiritual ways to deal with depression. Like, there's just some people that are naturally depressed or feel that they're naturally depressed. And they don't know how to get out of it. They're like, oh my God, I just get this bad feeling sometimes and I'm just so depressed and I don't know how to get out of it. Well, I used to be depressed as a teenager. And I know you're saying all teenagers are moody. But I was depressed for a little while after that too, like in my 20s. But as I began to realize what depression actually was, it was easy to get out of. So, when someone feels depressed, there's two ways to fix it. Mind, which is kind of hard if you don't know what the source of your depression is. And environment. If you are in an environment that is depressing, that makes you depressed, that makes you feel depressed, then that's one aspect of it. So, if it's your environment, you need to change your environment. Like, also, it could also be a vitamin D deficiency. Like, a lot of people who don't get enough vitamin D often have depression because there is a chemical in your brain that needs to be there in abundance. Vitamin D, sunshine. So make sure you're taking all your vitamins, especially vitamin D, getting lots of sunlight and water, okay? Now those are a few physical things. If you're eating too much sugar, once you're up high and hyper and then you come down low and you crash, this is the same with caffeine, and you crash, you'll get like a depressed feeling. So try to stay away from things that make you crash, like lots of sugar or lots of caffeine. Unless you're really used to caffeine and you don't crash from it, try to stay away from things that make you crash. If you do drugs, like if you smoke marijuana or you do like whatever drugs you do and 1 minute you're high, once you come off that high, it's like there's nowhere else to go but down, you know? You're not used to living in the norm if you're always on drugs. And so the opposite of being high then becomes the low becomes your normal, if you know what I mean. So if you're not high and you're normal, that's low. That's depressing to you. So if you're on drugs and you feel like you're depressed, try to like lessen up on the drugs and live in reality. Because if your reality is your low and your depression and you need drugs, I mean, it's not going to help you. Okay. Next, the spiritual way. All is vibration, okay? If you're feeling depressed, it's because of your vibration is low. And it's also because you're thinking too much. Either you're thinking too much in the past or you're thinking too much into the future and you're not living for today. Because most people that live for today, they're not depressed. If you're depressed over something that happened years ago, months ago, days ago, then that's why, because you're living in the past. If you're depressed about something that's going to happen in your future, or you're worried about something in your future and it's depressing, then you're living and worried about something that hasn't even happened yet. You understand? So try to live in the present. Try to live one day at a time. You know, that's what they tell drug addicts and alcoholics, to live one day at a time. Because a lot of people suffer from depression because they're worried or they're thinking too much or they just feel sad or sorry for themselves. And when I say when you feel sorry for yourself, there's another spiritual way to fix that as well. Start a gratitude journal. Or you don't even have to start your own. You can just name all the stuff that you're thankful and grateful that you do have. Okay, but it's better to write it down so you can go back and read it when you start having that depressed feeling. So you get your journal and you write down, I am so grateful for, you know, my car that works. Because some people don't have a car, okay? They have to walk or catch the bus. So be thankful for that. And say, oh, I'm thankful for my health. You know, I don't have cancer. I don't have a disease. I'm very healthy. I'm probably going to live a long time. No, write all the stuff that you do have. And once you finish that list, as far as you can think and go, and your hand probably going to get tired because you have so much to be thankful for, you're not going to feel depressed anymore. You're going to be like, oh my God, wow, I'm so stupid. Why am I feeling sad? I have everything I need. I have, you know, I have water to drink. I don't have to starve to death. I have a good education. My kids love me. You know, I have money in my pocket. You know, you're going to start seeing the light side, you know. You're not going to start seeing, woe is me. Oh, I just don't feel good today. Because you know what? If you think about this, now really think about this. The poorest people in the world do not suffer from depression. Why? Because they're not worried about tomorrow or yesterday. They're worried about today and their moments and life, and they have so little that they're very grateful for it. So they have nothing bad to focus on because the little things that they do have, they're happy to have them. You know, their health might not be as good. They might not have as much material items, but they're happy because they don't focus on what they don't have and what yesterday was and what tomorrow is going to be. They're living life for today because they value their life. They don't know when it's going to be over. So, you know, you always see the kids playing with like sticks and bottles and making instruments out of them from like Africa. And they're just sitting there like that's the best toy in the world. You know, they don't have any depression because they don't have so much that they forgot to be thankful for, you know? So try being thankful for the stuff that you have. And that should bring you out of your depression really quick. And just do that every day until you start disciplining yourself to stop feeling sorry for yourself and to stop feeling sad for yourself. Because, you know, you have so much to be grateful for and thankful for that it's really up to you to understand yourself and why you are depressed. You know, if you're not living for today, if you're not thankful for what you have, then I'm sure you would be depressed. You know, and I'm not laughing at people. I'm just saying, sometimes we overlook things and we overthink things and we forget to be thankful for things and we take everything for granted. It's kind of like being so rich that you have everything you want and now there's nothing else to live for. And a lot of rich people have this problem. And so they start doing crazy stuff, right? Or they start collecting weird things because they're so wrapped up in certain ways of thinking. They overthink everything. They're not just happy with the simple things of life. Some people will just become super creative. You know, if you're depressed, create something. Draw a picture. Write a poem. Write your way out of your depression. Write what you want to happen in your life. Write what will keep you from being depressed. You know, write stuff. Most people's depression often creates masterpieces like artwork and poems and poetry and novels. So just start creating, you know. You will create yourself out of depression. And if you know, some people, they just love to suffer. If you're a person that loves to suffer, then subconsciously, you don't want to be out of your depression because you identify too much with it, and that's who you are, that's who your personality is, and you're afraid to let it go because you don't know who you are. So if you're one of those kind of people, you need to figure out who you are and what you want. You know? If you want to be that lonesome, sorrow, depressed person, if that's your personality, if that's how you get your attention, then that's who you're going to be, because that's who you choose to be. Also, hanging around kids will help you get out of depression easy, because they'll make you forget everything. Kids live in the moment. They live for today. They're not thinking about yesterday. They're not thinking about tomorrow. They're thinking about right now. And if you hang around kids or witness kids or watch cartoons and silly stuff, watch some old cartoons from when you were a kid. Watch some old Disney movies or whatever from when you were a kid that made you feel good. Go to a place where you feel good and safe and comfortable and you can laugh. Comedies will help you get out of depression. Watch some comedies, some stand-up comedians, and just laugh your way out of depression. Because laughter releases that chemical that releases endorphins, and then you're just happy naturally from chemicals in your body, okay? So try that and see if it works. If not, you know, I don't suggest like medicine, you know, pills or anything, because half of those side effects are suicide. So you don't want to do that. So just try a few things that I suggested and see if that helps. If not, then, you know, I'm sure you'll outgrow it. A lot of people do. Or you might have, you know what, I suggest hypnosis sometimes. Find a hypnotist or you know what, a past life reading. You know, I'm going to promote myself. A lot of people are depressed and they don't know why. They're like, why the hell am I depressed? A lot of stuff is carried over from your past life. And until you know what that is exactly, you can't let it go. Because you don't know what it is. You don't remember it. So a past life reading could actually help you understand why you're depressed and what things you suffered. And sometimes it just clicks and say, you know what? That's my old life. I can set this down. I can let that go. You know, now I'm going to move on. So if you have like major depression and you have tried everything, try past life reading and see if that helps. Because, you know, it wouldn't hurt. And plus you would know a little bit more about yourself from other lives. Okay, well, thanks for listening. I hope this helped you. I'll see y'all soon.